Hey everybody, and welcome to CGN's Marvel Monday. For the next couple weeks, and maybe even the next couple months, Josh and I are going to be focusing some of our content every Monday on Marvel Crisis Protocol. We're going to be bringing you battle reports, painting tutorials, unboxings, tactical tips, and our opinion of the game. This week, we have another painting tutorial by Josh, a quick and dirty recipe for Miles Morales, painting him mostly with contrast paints in less than an hour.
Hey everybody, it's Josh with Cool Guys Nation. I'm going to be doing a tutorial for you today. We're going to be doing Miles Morales Spider-Man for Marvel Crisis Protocol. I hope you enjoy. Please remember, share, like, hit that bell button. Do whatever you can do if you like the video. Thanks so much. We'll see you in a second. So we're gonna start with, I'm just kind of experimenting here, and we'll see how it works. But I am going to be doing Black Templar on Miles Morales. My thought process here is that I'm gonna completely work him up as black. And then I'm gonna go in on the lines and try to get them white. And then I'm gonna do contrast red over them. We'll see how it works. I'm not convinced that this is going to go well, but we can fail or succeed together. So the first step, of course, getting that Black Templar. Now, his very fingertips, I guess, don't need to be painted that black. So I'll probably skip his thumbs and the his fingertips. Those are still supposed to be red. And then I don't have to repaint them. Like I said, I'm really hoping this works out. Because that would make this paint scheme so much easier. Now, I've never tried this before. I haven't seen anybody else do this. So we're literally just going all out here and seeing what we can get. Just gonna make sure this black is on really nice because his main bodysuit is this black, but we don't want the black to look shabby. Be real careful how I apply this. We don't want lots of mist spots, pooling. So when we're doing this, just being real careful to hit all the spots. His crotchal area is not the easiest to reach. And I'm not worried too much if I go over on the mailbox here, because like I said before, we're just gonna be painting right over that. All right, well, that's step one. I actually decided to just do him all in white, and then we're gonna go over with the red later. Just too difficult to get the webs to look right without taking a long amount of time. And that's not what we're here for. We're trying to do quick paint, so that's the quick paint. I would actually not paint that that white, this white section that you're seeing here, if you were actually starting from fresh. Just avoid painting the black on where I've got the white. This is gonna take a little bit longer to dry, but it should work out for us just fine. And just wanted to make sure we got a good coat on him. We're gonna just wash this with the red, and we're gonna see what we can do to make that look better. We might actually end up doing a dry brush at the end. We'll see how it's gonna work at the start. And we are going to be dropping the Blood Angels red on him directly over this white, and should work out pretty well. I'm gonna go ahead and just be real careful with these parts that are coming over the black. And then when we get to the white, I'm not gonna be as worried. Actually, I want as much as possible for the red to go in the recesses and make it darker, because it's supposed to be dark. Now, I went over the eyes, but that was on purpose. I want to really get that red going, and I'm not gonna worry about working hardcore around those eyes again. Those will be easy enough to get some white in those when it's time. I wanna really try to get these areas complete and looking good with this red first. By the way, did I mention that Blood Angel's red is such a good contrast color? It just works so well. And I'm gonna see how it looks when we get back. I might do a second coat and try to pull off those top layers. We'll see. I think this is gonna be playable as soon as we get those eyes painted in. I'm really not super worried about getting all those webs. It's gonna be a beast. And I'd rather have it look clean than look perfect. Back with Miles, that red is still going. I'm actually gonna work on the little newspaper thing here. I'm gonna be painting the base of it, this green color, which is a Vallejo Model Air tank green. And I'm just gonna do the outside and the base of this as this color. Like I said, I'm gonna be washing any flat paints that I put down, either with contrast or a regular wash. So as long as base color's on there, good. That's all we're gonna need, especially if I'm gonna be washing with any contrast paints. You know, I don't think that I am gonna do anything else with this webbing, so I'm gonna go ahead and work on his eyes. And we're still waiting for the box to get its second coat. So I'm just gonna use a little Vallejo, that Vallejo white that I've got. And I'm just gonna start working on the eyes. And I'm gonna probably go in with a wash of that apothecary white over this eyes and then highlight this white because it just looks too stark right now. Yeah, so what we'll do after this dries, at least the eye part, we'll hit it with that the apothecary white and then we'll re-highlight with a dot of white. Gonna try a new technique here and I'm just gonna be dropping in these contrast black in between the webbings. It seems to be a lot easier than the other way around that I was doing. And it's giving the effect that we're looking for. We're not going to be able to do it everywhere. It's just not fine enough. But we can get the basic effect that we're looking for by just dotting these little areas in between the webbing, which is giving us the effect that we need, no problem. So I'm gonna need a steady hand for this. I'll be back and you'll see the effect. Okay, so yeah, this effect worked really well just doing the contrast in the holes, honestly. Looks much better now. And we'll be able to have a really good looking product with that. So we are gonna be doing this Altdorf blue for the front of it. You can see that my Altdorf blue is in great shape, as you can see, but it's good enough for us right now. Like I said, we're just gonna do this front area with the blue. And then we're gonna hit some silver on these two other pieces here. Here, here, the mechanism areas of the machine. And as we talked about before, we're gonna do that apothecary white over the eyes. And to make them less stark. And then we'll go back and highlight with some white when appropriate. We're gonna use that baby poop to wash the newspaper seller here. And I'm just gonna go over the silver here with this. That's totally fine. I'm gonna actually take some silver. I don't know why I didn't do this before, probably because it wasn't dry yet. And I'm gonna put silver on the little window for the newspapers. After that, we should be pretty much done. I guess I can put the whites on Spidey's eyes now as well. So just get a little of that Vallejo white again. Just gonna get a little dot and highlight that eye a little bit. There we go. Much better now, and we need to wait for it to dry. Should just be one more wash on the blue and the silver, and he'll be done. We're gonna use a little Dragonhof nightshade to just shade the blue and silver. We'll just pull some off of this guy here. I want a little bit of blue shade on that silver, but not that much. But that's Miles, he's done. I'm just gonna do the basing. If you wanna see how I finish up the basing, check out my Kingpin video. All right guys, as always, thanks for watching. If you like, please hit the subscribe button, hit the bell, give us a like on Facebook, and share us with your friends and enemies. Thanks so much and have a great day.